Hello everyone, and now I would like to show you an instructive chess game of the talented American chess player, James Leonard. And in this chess game, Leonard has the black pieces and his opponent is William Horner, who has the white pieces. And this game was played in a tournament in New York from 1860 in a place called Morphy Chess Rooms. So they probably made a chess club for honoring the name of Paul Morphy, for honoring Paul Morphy. And in this chess game, William Horner, who has the white pieces, starts the game with playing e4, e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, and bishop to c4. The Italian opening, Leonard played bishop to c5, c3, knight to f6, d4, exchanging the pawns, but not capturing back, e5, attacking the knight. Leonard played d5, attacking the bishop, b4, retreating and defending the bishop by Horner, knight to e4, defending the knight, c takes on d4, and Leonard castled, bishop takes on c6, b takes on c6, and also white castled, f6. Well, in this position, Leonard wants to open the f-file. This f-file could be dangerous. E takes on f6, and Leonard captured the pawn with a tempo. And maybe he's threatening to play bishop to g4, pinning the knight. That could be annoying for white. Well, after f6, bishop to e3 was the better move. F takes on e5, knight takes on e5, still opening the f-file, but not with a tempo. And this knight is looking good for white. Although black is slightly better in this position, let's get back to the real game. So after f6, we have e takes on f6, and then queen takes on f6, h3. After h3, white is not allowing bishop to g4. But what would you do in this position? Well, in this position, Leonard captured the pawn, bishop takes on h3, g takes on h3, and then queen takes on f3, temporarily sacrificing the bishop, and then getting back the material. Queen takes on f3, rook takes on f3, king to g2, defending the rook, bishop to e3, defending the pawn. Again, what would you do in this position? Leonard made his calculation. Can you see the winning combination in this position for black? Maybe white is still holding his ground. He is fighting back. Black has one extra pawn, but white is still in the ballgame, maybe. But Leonard saw the winning move, and Leonard played knight takes on f2. This was the winning move. Bishop takes on f2, and then rook takes on f2. Rook takes on f2. Rook takes rook. Check. King takes on f2. White has the rook, but only for a second. Leonard played bishop takes on d4. This is check. Forking the king and the rook. So as you can see, Leonard saw few moves ahead and then crushed his opponent. Horner played king to f3, and then Leonard captured the rook. Bishop takes on a1, and white resigned. What a game by Leonard. Well, white resigned because black has the massive material advantage. Black has 3 extra pawns, and this is losing for white. So again, this was the vicious, brutal winning combination. Knight takes on f2, bishop takes on f2. Exchanging the pieces, rook takes on f2. After king takes on f2, bishop takes on d4, forking the king and the rook. So, if you saw this, well done. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye-bye.